Hey everyone, welcome to Chatterbox Reviews. I'm Stan with my lovely wife Tanya, and we're doing a special review on Daredevil Season 1. I got no complaints with this series, like it's out now, it's already available, 13 episodes, and this is basically a 13 episode origin story. It's just one big movie, and I've really loved the fact that like they didn't just go, oh yeah, well this just a superhero runs around and saves the day. They went really gritty with this. They took it to, like, you know, places where, you know, a lot of comics and, like, comic shows don't go.
It's what you want to see in a Daredevil show.
Yeah, so. Hard, like, kind of R rating for it and stuff. It gets a little bit violent here and there, but it's still good. It, like, ties in with a lot of real-life, like, kind of workings. What did you think, like, so far?
I thought it was really good. I enjoyed every episode, and I'm sad that season one's over, but I'm looking forward to season two.
And plus, like, too, season two has been approved and stuff. They're recording it now, and they showed us a quick, small, like, little few seconds of what's in store. We've got Frank Castle coming in, who is aka the Punisher, Elektra, who you're looking forward to.
Yeah, I can't wait for that.
Do you reckon she'll have the size and stuff, or it'll be an origin sort of for her?
No, I reckon she'll have the size.
Yeah.
Yeah, I reckon she's already full-on badass and ready to go.
Like, we get this quick shot of her putting on the red mask, and we see a quick shot of, like, Frank Castle in there saying bang at the end. But, yeah, I don't know, like, when exactly they're going to premiere season two of Daredevil, but Jessica Jones is in the same world and is tying in, so we're going to do a quick review on the trailer that's come out. You see Elektra, it looks all badass. But, yeah, there's the Punisher skull and stuff. But anyway, we'll get into Elektra and Jessica Jones in a sec. Right now, actually. Bang, we're back. Freaking Jessica Jones time. So, this is yours. Take the lead.
I'm really looking forward to Jessica Jones. I think it's awesome. You know, just to see any possibilities of what she's capable of. Just maybe flashbacks of what she used to be like, maybe as Jewel, who she used to be a superhero and, you know, try and save people, but, you know.
That's comic book-like kind of element. That territory is, like, it's not off limits with the show, I think. Like, they put so much into Daredevil that I was like, wow, they actually, like, really adapted that to real-life kind of style. Yeah, I don't know, like, exactly how they're going to go about it.
Should be pretty interesting, you know, where they take Jessica Jones and, you know, what her villains will be. We already know that the Purple Man's going to make an appearance, you know, not for the first time as well. So hopefully the flashbacks will go back to his interactions with Jessica and, you know, what happened to her possibly, because she seems pretty messed up about it all.
Well, like what we see here, she's crushing her alarm clock. That's kind of hinting at, like, all right, we're off and running. Like, I hope they do that with the first episode.
Well, it looks like she's been up all night, you know, investigating something, so she wants a good sleep in.
Yeah, she's alias, you know, private investigator. Like, you know, she's a PI. So basically, I think that they are going to hint at, like, yeah, she possibly was a detective at one point. She was on the force, and then she's left it. She's done horrible deeds because of the Purple Man. Purple Man's our villain.
That's how badass this bit is, you know, her walking through the pub.
And it's just freaking bodies everywhere from who she's knocked out or someone's crossed her and tried
to... I'd like to know why she's beat up everybody. I think it'll be quite interesting. Oh,
someone's tried to pick a fight with her and underestimated her because, like, she's just this silly-looking girl, like, you know.
She's not silly. She's cool.
Well, she's, like, seen in the trailer lifting cars and stuff. But substance abuse. She's drinking. She's got things on her mind and stuff. But
she's trying to drown out.
Yeah.
Sorrows.
Just to, like, you know, all right, we're getting rid of freaking all this past and stuff, just drinking it away and stuff. But it's really cool, like, that they are...
They're going to touch on all her, you know, human traits as well as, you know, all her extra, you know, stuff, which is really cool.
And in the Daredevil series, like, it actually had flashbacks to when he was a kid. I think they'll do flashbacks to what she was doing when she was a... She was what?
She can fly.
Well, she can leap high, I think. I don't think she can really take complete flight. I don't think that'd make her kind of too overpowered. But
well,
then again,
she wasn't a very, you know, experienced flyer when she was a superhero, so.
Yeah.
It'd be interesting.
But I don't know exactly, like, where they're going to go with the series. I'm just excited for it. The trailers are, like, sold me big time. I mean, Daredevil's sort of set us up for the tone of what this neighborhood and what this city, like, Hell's Kitchen is like. So that's another thing I keep saying to everyone. Like, you know, if you want to watch Jessica Jones, watch, like, Daredevil first. Watch that and see what it's like. But apparently this show is taking a different tone.
So I think it's more gritty.
Yeah, pretty much. But also just some of the different things that they go through this trailer with is that, yeah, we're going to explore, like, not just her story, but other characters' stories, because Luke Cage is going to have his own spin-off series followed with an Iron Fist series, and then they'll have it with the Defenders, where Daredevil, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage and Iron Fist all get together and say, New York's got Avengers to, like, save the world, but who's going to save, like, this small part of town, Hell's Kitchen?
Who's going to look after the small crimes?
Yeah, who's going to defend it? We can defend it. Like, so it's pretty interesting. They've established she's got superpowers. She's obviously going to have flashbacks. Can you think of anything else?
Not really. I mean, the flashbacks will be very interesting to go through, and all the torture and stuff, like I said before, and maybe her possibly meeting Luke Cage either for the first time in the series
She's going to get a relationship, and that's going to be kind of cute to see Power Man and, like, you know, Power Girl.
I just like the dark tone that this TV series is going to have, and I'm really excited and I can't wait.
Yep. She's gritty. She's flawed. She's freaking awesome. She kicks ass. That's Jessica Jones preview.
Let us know your thoughts on what you think about the Jessica Jones trailer. And check us out on Twitter, Instagram, or Facebook.
Cool.
Thanks. Bye.